If you're constantly feeling pain at the front of your hip or your groin area, then stay tuned because today I'm going to show you some exercise to start fixing that problem. Let's go! Hi, I'm Melanie the Physio, also the co-founder of Capital Physiotherapy here in Australia. Painful groin area or right at the front of the hip area is one of the most common things that we see in our clinic these days. And it generally happens to people who sit a lot, so a lot of office people, gamers, or people who drive a lot for their work, or people who actually enjoy riding bikes a lot. They generally tend to have this problem. Now your hip flexor will be tight if you're constantly putting them in a shortened position. And the major hip flexor in our body is the iliopsoas muscle, and it attaches from your spine all the way to the front of your hip. If this muscle gets tight, it will pull on your spine. That's why a lot of people will start experiencing lower back discomfort as well when they have tight hip flexor. Now, what this does is when it's pulling on your spine, it actually completely changed the alignment of your pelvis as well, leading to this sort of forward sitting position, like what I've shown in the picture. And what happened is, in this position, you will have a harder time to activate your core muscle and to activate your glute muscles. So over time, if you constantly adopt this sort of posture, you would have a weak glute muscles and a weak core muscles that come with it as well. And it's a very vicious cycle. And the symptom will start to get worse. It will start from hip tightness that you constantly feel the front of your hip being sore, to slight lower back discomfort, to actually back pain, and so on and so forth. A lot of people with hip flexor tightness as well will start to complain that they feel clicking at the front of their hip, or popping sensation at the front of our hip. Now, we have a video that specifically talks about this issue, so I highly recommend that you check them out after this video. So today in this video, I will show you some exercise that you can do to help stretch out your hip flexor muscles, and also some exercise to start strengthening those muscles that will get weak because you have a tight hip flexor. Now the first one is the hip flexor stretch. So all I want you to do is come into a kneeling position, making sure that your hip is directly underneath your knee. And a lot of people do this exercise wrong by leaning too far forward. If you lean too far forward, you're arching your lower back. And because the iliopsoas is attached to your lower back, if you move your lower back, you won't be stretching this muscle anymore. So all you need to do is keeping your hip directly underneath your knee. And all I want you to do is tuck your hip forward. So sort of push your hip tailbone forward into like a scooping sensation and flattening that lower back of yours. And you will find that without leaning forward, you will feel a stretch right at the front of your thigh straight away. I want you to hold that position for about 30 to 40 seconds and repeat that for 3 to 4 repetitions. Now the next stretch that I'm going to teach you is what we call a piriformis stretch. A lot of people with pinching at the front of your hip pain tend to have tightness with this muscle as well. So all I want you to do is sitting on your chair, making sure that you pick a chair that is as low as possible. The lower the chair is, the better you will stretch this muscle. Now I want you to hook your ankle onto your opposite knee. Now, and all I want you to do is straighten your spine and lean forward. Just by doing so, you should feel a stretch at the back of your hip all the way down to the side of your leg, and that's the correct muscle. All I want you to do again is to hold it for 30 to 40 seconds, repeat that for about 3 to 4 repetitions. If you find this video helpful so far, don't forget to click the subscribe button right now, because we're gonna have a lot more hip related video coming up in the near future. Now the next exercise is what we call a clam exercise. Now you can do this with or without a resistance band. I'm gonna do it with the resistance band today, and I'll put a link down in the description box below on where you can get them online. Now all I want you to do is lying on your side, making sure that your hip is stacked on top of each other, that you're not rolling too far forward or too far back. All I want you to do is making sure that your heel is in line with your hip. And all I want you to do is keep your hip nice and still and keep your ankle together and open up your knee and then close it. Repeat this process for about 20 repetitions until you feel that your hip or your bum muscles is working. Do that for 20 repetitions and try to do it for about 3 to 4 sets. Now the next exercise is hip flexor strengthening. A lot of the time, because your hip flexor is shortened, you won't activate them properly, and in terms over time, these muscles actually starts to get weaker and weaker. So all I want you to do is stand on a fairly high chair, put your leg on that high chair, and all I want you to do is lift your leg off the chair and putting it down again, lifting it up and down. And you should feel that the front of your thigh, right where the front of your hip groin pain is, that muscle is really working very hard. Now, repeat this process for about 15 repetition and do that for about 3 to 4 sets as well. Now, another thing that is important that you want to look at is what is the root of the problem? What is causing you to have a tight hip flexor to begin with? And a lot of the time, like I say, it's because you're sitting for too long. So all you need to do is start changing that habit. So because if you're doing the same habit all the time, no matter how much you stretch it, no matter how much you strengthen it, you keep falling back to that bad habit, which leads to this problem to begin with. So start changing your habits, start standing up a little bit more, get a sit-stand desk. If you're working in an office all the time, or if you're a gamer, start getting a sit-stand desk, start having a better workstation set up, and just getting out of your static sitting position as often as you can, and in turn you'll find that as you start breaking these habits, you will stop having this problem altogether once and for all. Now I do have other videos that will help with your hip and groin issues, so make sure you check them out. I'm Melanie and I upload video here on a weekly basis on health and fitness related topic as well as injury rehab topic. Once again, I will see you in the next video. Until then, stay safe, happy and healthy, and good luck with your exercises. See ya!